my service rate is up. You know, I'm breeding more cows, so I'm getting more pregnancies. And that's what I think makes the difference.
Hello, I'm Aaron Dukelow.
Greg Dukelow from Dukestead Acres. We're located at Abbotsford, Wisconsin.
My name is John Dukelow. We've been farming in Abbotsford since 1998. Built a freestall barn with a parlor in 99.
The parlor's starting to show a little wear and stuff, so we decided that we'd look into the robots. My older brother and me maybe weren't quite as gung-ho on getting robots at first, but my nephew and my other brother, you know, kind of wanted to go that route. But once we got the system and, you know, the BA system, I don't think I'd do it without it anymore, just for the fact that you look on, when you get there in the morning, you look on the computer and you can see the cows that are in heat, you see the cows that maybe that are not quite doing as good, and, you know, you can just take one look, and before you even go in the barn, you kind of know what to look for and what to expect. The BA, it's another tool in the toolbox. It tells you, you know, her rumination, if she's in heat, you know, it's a big tool to have. I can be sitting in a tractor and, you know, see which cows where, or, you know, what they're doing, and just, it is nice. You know, it definitely improves, you know, your herd. Now looking back, I was like, there's no question I'd want to do this again, you know.
I always check the behavior analysis list. It works so well with Chai, and it puts all that extra information there. We had the robots up and running for about 2 months without that, and even the Chai report then was amazing, but now with all this extra information, it really helps, because, you know, you could see that a cow dropped on milk or something, but now this tells you that beforehand and tells you why, if they're rumination, something's up with that, temperatures. If a cow goes into heat and she doesn't show much, the BA tags still pick up on it. Or if it's, you know, during the night when we're not here, it'll tell us that, and it gives us the optimal time to breed it. The location was probably the first thing we got used to with all the behavior analysis in that aspect. It, you know, it took a little while to gain all the data we needed, and the system learns on its own and adapts to each cow individually. But we're really seeing the results now. The cows, you definitely don't see them all just by pen or as a herd now. You see the cows individually. Yeah, each one got its own personality, behaves different. And it's just amazing to see how much that's changed just since we put the robots in. The cows have adapted so well to this system.
We would be running like around a 26-27% preg rate, and a service rate of always seemed to be right around 56%. And kind of going with this system, I wanted to get my preg rate like around 30% or better. And since then, our service rate's been, I think it's up to 67% right now, and the preg rate is 31. We're catching more cows in heat with the BA system because it's always watching the cows, or, you know, you don't have that 4-hour gap where nobody sees the cows. We get activity on every cow every day. It's about efficiencies, right? I can come in the barn in the morning, look at the computer, and I can see what the cows are eating, what they're ruminating, who my sick cows are, all in the first 5 minutes that I'm in the barn. You know, I don't have to go look at every cow to know what every cow is doing. Your time is valuable. You need to be doing things that you can be getting the most stuff done at the quickest, I guess.
I highly recommend it. If, you know, you are looking for a system, it has definitely been holding up really well, and, you know, is pretty pinpoint on too, so we really like it.